Hello everyone, welcome back. Thank you for tuning in and being here today. I'd like to thank my patrons who help me vote every week on a topic I should teach. And this week we will be focusing on painting a road, like almost like a road trip overseeing like the mountain and some trees on the side. And and so I'm excited and let's see what happens with this. I'd like to remind, if you'd like to see these videos ad-free and or give a vote on what topic I should teach next, please check out the link up here or in the description. All right, let's get straight to it and go over the materials needed for today. We need a couple of these blending brushes. And as I always say, if you have one will work as well, but it's easier with two. We need a couple of these artist loft brushes. This is a number 8 and a number 4. Any half an inch flat brush. And any detail brush for the details. And that's it for the brushes. For the paints, I like to use acrylics, and we need titanium white, cadmium medium yellow, naphthol medium red, ultramarine blue, and carbon black. We need a palette of some sort, a palette knife to mix your colors. And I'm using this palette paper, which comes in a lot of sheets, and I just put it on my palette board right here so that it'll be easier to just, once I'm done, I just kind of take it out and throw it away. Very easy instead of scraping off and trying to clean and spend time doing that. But you can use any palette you have available. We need some paper towels, a jar of water, and if you have this, great. You can use this hair blow dryer to dry out your first coats, and I'll show you. Or once we have our background sky laid down, you know, when it starts to dry out, we can take a break, wash a couple of our brushes, and while our background is drying. And I'll show you. I'm using a 16 by 20 inch canvas here. And I believe that's it for materials. We can start mixing our paint. So first things first, let's pick up our titanium white and our palette. And then we're going to create a couple shades. We're gonna make our sky kind of bluish and with some clouds, white clouds. So we're gonna make it not as colorful. So let's just make like 3 or 4 shades, starting off with 3 first. So first I'm gonna just squeeze out about this much, and then a little bit, pretty much the same, okay? And then maybe a little less, like this, on the third one, right there. We might add some more, but let's just go with this for now. And then let's take our blue, ultramarine blue, and we will put it, let's put it a little bit in here, a lot more in here, and let's just mix those colors real quick right there, and then we'll add some more if we need to. So our palette knife. And let's just mix this color here first. It's gonna give us a light bluish color right here, as you could see. And we're gonna leave that white right there. We're gonna use that for clouds. The sky will be kind of similar to the colors, I mean, will be similar to the painting that we did with the daffodils and the way we painted our clouds. So very simple right there. And then our third shade should be a darker blue. And if your shade is a little bit, you know, it doesn't have to be exactly like mine. I always say this. It could be a little lighter or darker, as long as you get the, that, you know, from lightest to darkest. As long as you have that, you're good. Right there. All right, so I decided to add a little bit of yellow. So let's pick up our yellow and just add a touch of yellow here. I just want to make it a little bit greener right there, and then a touch right there, just like that, just a touch, okay? And then we're going to add a little more white here because I think that blue is a little too dark and I want my sky to be not so dark. So I'll show you how much I added in a bit. Right there, you could see. And let's go ahead and mix this first. It has a little bit that hint of green in there, in my blue, and that's what we want. I think I'm going to add just a little bit more white here, okay? Because I feel like once it dries, it's going to be a little bit dark. So let's just add a little more white, okay? Just a little bit there and a little bit on the side. I'll show you. Show you what I'm doing. Right here. So I added a little more here, just a touch. And then a little more white right there. So let's mix that. And, you know, I'm playing with the paint and the colors and see what I like, how I want my sky to look like. And that's better right there. That's much better. Okay, next. I'm going to just mix this one and we'll be ready to lay these colors down on our canvas. Right there. Let's quickly add these colors on our palette and, or I mean our canvas, and we're going to have our mountains be right about there, so we're gonna go probably like, you know, about this much, like a third of the way, and cover the canvas. So let's pick up our blending brush and our water jar and dab it halfway and then squeeze it out. So not too much, just gently squeeze it out. And then we're going to just pick up our, let's just start with this color right here. Okay, just pick that all, you know, put it on your brush like this. And we're gonna just add some in here. And pick more of this color and maybe add some in here. I'm gonna dab my brush just a tip in the water like this, and then pick up more. Maybe go up like this. Okay, let's now, I'm gonna dab the tip again in the water, and then pick up my darkest, and then let's add that right in here and just cover it. Just cover everything else. Okay, dab the tip in the water. And then that, dab the tip in the water again. And just cover everything. Maybe pick up some more of this color here. You almost won't even see that much of a difference. That's okay. This color is just our base, okay? We're just trying to cover our background. I'm gonna quickly blend those in and then add our clouds. Okay, and now I'm gonna actually dab the brush in the water and let's pick up some of this white for fun. Just a little bit, just straight white. And let's add it right in here. Maybe in here, just on the bottom a little bit. You won't even be able to tell that much. There, that's good enough. That's fine. So now, since I have two brushes, I'm gonna pick up my second blending brush and quickly blend that in and start from the bottom and go over the lighter areas first. So I'm gonna swirl it gently and just go over the lighter areas first. Just swirl it and gently pull the paint upwards. Don't worry about trying to, if some of the, you know, the brush, the hairs come out from the brush, don't worry about trying to pluck it out or take it out, because you'll just have a hard time doing that. Wait till the painting is dry and then you can easily take them out. They fall out easily when you scratch them out. So every brush does this, but this blending brush is the best so far I've tried. But you could see I'm blending and pulling the paint upwards and just quickly roughly blend everything. Take away the brush strokes and that creates a nice soft shade transition to the darker color, and then just go around those areas. Pull the paint upwards and swirl it gently. I'm like almost like lightly pressing and dabbing using a dry brush, and just cover everything. Go over everything nicely, smoothly. Take away the brush strokes, and here you have it. You have your nice smooth background ready to go. Now I'm gonna let this dry. So while my first layer is drying, I'm gonna quickly just rinse out these blending brushes and get a new water. All right, and now I'm gonna quickly dry this out with the hair blow dryer. All right, now that it's dry, remember there's a few hairs that came out. Like for example, I only have one right now, right here. And the background is dry and I just quickly just peel it out like this and it falls out. Doesn't damage the paint, nothing, because it's already dry and nicely sealed. So here you go, very easy and no problem. And now we can continue adding some more clouds and details. So let's pick up our palette with some paint that we have, the titanium white, just titanium white, and we're gonna use this number 4 artist loft brush, dab it in the water. So I'm going like this, trying to make it damp, okay? And now that my brush is pretty nice and wet, I will go ahead and pick up some titanium white, just like this. And I'm going to just randomly add some clouds, you know, in here, maybe some clouds going out like this, you know, very, very nice and easy. You know, yours could look a little different than mine, or a lot different. Create it in your own style, you know, do something that you haven't done before, challenge yourself. I always want you to challenge yourself, because I find so much fun and joy in that, when you step out of your comfort zone to do something different, or to paint something, or to try a new material. That always is a fun. I think you will enjoy that a lot more when you challenge yourself and try something that is hard. I'm still working on that myself, and every time I challenge myself, I always am growing, whether I can, you know, feel it or see it or not. My mind is growing and ideas are growing, and eventually they naturally come to life at some point. So I'm gonna just quickly add that right in here. You see I'm just randomly making my clouds and just fade it out here. Fade it out. Since my brush has some white and water, it runs nice and smooth on my canvas. I'm gonna dab the tip of my brush in the water just a little bit to get more water and pick up more titanium white. And let's go up here a little higher. Let's go all the way up and then maybe fade it out in there. Your shapes of clouds could be different than mine. And I'm swirling and taking that white and blending it, and I'm pressing a little bit firm, you know, like nice and firm when I'm blending the paint outwards to make a nice smooth transition. And you could have some, could, you know, some could be sharp. Some could be not so sharp, totally up to you. I'm gonna carry this out like this. Dab my brush in the water. And if you took a little too much water, just dab it in your paper towel, just a little bit to dry it out a little. And then just pick up some more white and carry on. So I'm gonna just add a little bit of white in here, some clouds. Some sharper ones. I'm going to add a little bit of clouds in here. Just like this. And we are moving on. And then I think I'm going to connect this in here. Okay, moving on. I want to make this a little brighter here, so I'm going to add a little more white. Water and white. And a little bit of transparent white clouds up in here. Moving on, just white and water. And add some sharper white in here. Dab my brush in the water. More titanium white. And then I'm going to bring a cloud down here. Maybe softly connecting. And just fade it out here in the bottom. But yours, again, you can add your clouds wherever you want them to be. Make this a little more white. Maybe a little more white in here. Continue dabbing my brush in the water. And let's move on. And where we left off right here, maybe connecting those somehow. And then keep forward, move forward, and add your shapes of clouds. It doesn't have to, there's no right or wrong. Create them the way you see your clouds up in the sky. And as I go up on some areas, I'm adding a little bit of white, not too much, and I'm using more water to have that nice transition, soft transition. and if you want to make some of them a little more brighter, just use white, more white. Once the area starts to dry out, go back and fill in the areas where you want a little more white showing, you know what I mean? Dab my brush in the water, and we're almost done with, you know, adding some clouds here. We're gonna go over some of these. And just, I'm pressing hard and fading the paint out when I want it to fade. I think I'm gonna add a nice glow in here. So I'm gonna just use white. Dab my brush in the water again and continue using this white. I'm gonna fade it out here. You know, a lot of this, the bottom part is will be covered with mountains, so you know, I might not see part of this here, so just keep that in mind. I went down lower on purpose, but we're gonna cover it about this much everywhere. Dab my brush in the water. I think I'm going to fade it out here. So now I added just a touch of ultramarine blue, and if you have a little bit of this left, that's, you know, that'll be nice if you can take that and just mix it in with this ultramarine blue. Just mix it in real quick. I just want it a little darker than the color we have here, just a little bit like this. Okay. There you go. And now we're going to use the same brush. I'm going to clean the white out just in the water. And same idea and same technique. We're going to take this color, darker color, and on some of these areas, like right here, I'm going to add it and underneath you know, this, the brighter colors of the clouds, and I want to fade it out. So I'm going to dab my brush in the water again, just a little bit, and let's continue just underneath the white. And I think I'm going to fade it out here. Same idea, just press a little bit as you go up and blend those colors in with the background. Okay, just like that. Let's use a little bit of this color and let's add just a little bit of blue inside here. Want this to stand out. Some in here. Same thing here, remember this cloud underneath? Same idea. You can fade it out. And dab my brush in the water again. Moving on, let's add a little bit of blue in here. Just a little bit like this. There you go. And maybe a little bit in here. Fade out. Same thing here. Dab my brush in the water. You know, like maybe make some little ones in here. Like they break apart in the cloud. So I'm just gonna dab a few. And you could see that dark blue sky. I'm going to add that blue here. And then just color in this blue. And just fade it out as you go up. Maybe I'm gonna cover this with blue as well right here. All right. Clean my brush and fade this out because I wanted this to have a little bit of more blue. Just have it fade out like this. I think I'm gonna cover this with blue a little bit in here. Dab my brush in water and use the same blue, and I think I'm gonna just create a couple sharp ones here. There you go. All right. Let's add a little bit of blue in here. I want this to stand out a lot in here. So let's bring this blue down and just fade it out right here. Few more details here on this cloud. Let's add a little bit of this blue right underneath this cloud. We just want to make some of these stand out a little more and fade it out. Okay, and then maybe with the water a little bit, connect it maybe like this in here just a little bit. fade it out, because I want this to be pretty bright. Like this. And I'm gonna use a little bit of the white here. Just a little bit of the white, and I'm gonna add a few more clouds in here. Kind of try to blend it in with the blue. So I'm just using water. Just a little bit of this blue and white, and fade it out. Clean my brush a bit, take some of the blue and water. And just go over some just with the white and blue. Just play around here, blend them in, maybe add a little bit of the blue up in here. Go. And I'm going to add a few more details right here. Same thing, just around this corner, just the blue, fade it out. And now I'm going to add a little more white, just pure white, on some of these areas, because I want some of these to be very bright where the blue is. I want that blue to stand out a lot. So I'm just gonna go over some of these, okay? Here. And we'll be good with our clouds. Just pure white, no water this time. I'm going to add a little bit of more blue in here. And just fade it out like this. A little bit of blue in here and fade it out. Just fade it out like this. And you can spend a lot of time detailing these clouds, but we're gonna move on, okay? Let's move on. We can always come back to it and add more, touch it up and add more details, okay? I'm having way too much fun with this. And I can get carried away easily, so I really need to stop and move on. Okay, so now that we have our background, like I said, we can go back and detail it and spend time and as much as we want on everything here, but let's continue and add our mountains now. Okay, moving on. We have just a little bit of white and a little bit of white, a touch of blue and a little bit of yellow. And then here we have more blue, about the same amount of white and a touch of yellow as well. And then here we've got about the same amount of blue, a touch of black, very small amount, a little bit of white, less than these two, and a touch of yellow. So let's go ahead and mix our lightest right here. Let's see what colors it gives us. So we should be getting a similar color like these between these two. Right here. Okay. That's good enough. All right, our second shade should be darker with a hint of yellow in it, so it makes it look a little bit green, but still leaning towards blue more. We basically want a color that is going to be darker than the sky. So this darkest blue that we have here, that's this one, we want to have this be a little bit darker, just a little bit. So I'm looking at it, you know, and I could add a little bit more blue in there. So let's do that real quick. Just a touch of blue. Just a small amount right there. And let's mix that in. And we should have it good. We should be ready to mix our final shade for the mountain. Right here. This one should be the darkest. But not too dark. Still want it to be light because these are mountains far away, so they're gonna look still bluish. That's why I added a little bit of black to just make it a little darker than this one. As you could see, we have three shades, and now we can draw out the shape of our mountains how we want them to be. So now I'm gonna take my 1/2 inch flat brush, dab it in the water. And let's start with this blue here that we mixed. So I'm going to dab my brush in the water and pick up a little bit of paint, and I'm going to draw the shapes of my mountains, okay? So again, like I said, remember I went down lower on purpose, so I'm going to go a little bit higher. So I'll start from here and I'm going to draw my first mountain, you know, and your shapes can be a little bit different than mine, okay? The mountain shape, I mean. So I'm gonna go down a bit and then I'm gonna go up here. Like this. I'm gonna keep going up and take some more paint. Keep going up, maybe go down a bit, So this will go like this. So now I'm going to dab my brush in the water and draw my shadows. So quickly sketch out my shadows, and I might change the way this looks. We'll see how it'll turn out, but let's just pretend, let's just start from here and draw out the shadows like this. Okay, so using the same color. So I'm gonna draw this a little bit in. You know how the snow is. So just pretend there's a bunch of shadows and rocks in your snow. And then this part, we're gonna just bring it up and then bring it down. Just bring it down and carry out like this. We can fix it later, and then maybe here, you know, we'll have a little mountain. And just go follow this white pattern, and let's bring it down about right here. I'm gonna draw my shadows here. And I'm going to cover all this. Just roughly add in my shadows. Okay, moving on. I'm gonna make a little mountain here, little bumps, a few little hills here, and just fade it out like this. Maybe connect it to this one. Done adding our shadows here, first layers, I mean. Okay. All right, let's switch to our Artist Loft number 8 brush, dab it in the water, and quickly let's continue, you know, Let's add this dark one and maybe mix it in a little bit here and just add that right on top right here. Just bring it down. No, maybe not everywhere, just fade it out like this. Okay, so let's take this, same thing here, and then I'm gonna dab my brush in the water, use this color. And just fade it out like this. Take the darkest color now, and let's just add random. This is our base, okay? So let's just cover this, pretend that there's another hill that goes up like this. Next, let's continue covering this up until this point right here. Until like this point, okay? Right in here, like this. So let's just take all this and our base. And we're gonna add a little more colors, of course. But just for now, let's just add this darkest color here. Ready then? Now I'm gonna rinse out my brush and then continue adding my highlights, but let's go ahead and add the white. Let's go over it with just the white, pure white, and add the snow really quick. Just the snow. We're gonna come back with the details in a bit, but let's just add our lights and darks first. Just the white. We'll continue with it. Maybe there are some faraway mountains. Some snow far away. All right, let's use this color now. And it's okay if you get mix it in with the white a little bit, that's fine. Let's just actually let's mix it with the white. I think I made it a little too dark. Just cover the canvas wherever you might think that there needs a little canvas cover. Just real quick, roughly blend those in. I'm going to use my blending brush to blend some of those in real quick. Actually, maybe I'm not. Let's see if, because there's, you could see the brush strokes, right? And to remove them, it actually might help. So quickly dab my blending brush in the water, just, and then squeeze it out, and just with the a little bit of water, and I'm gonna softly blend in the areas where I see brush strokes. And then this is our base with the mountain, so don't focus on, you know, spending too much time, because we're just adding the base. We're gonna add more details just in a minute. Okay, that's good enough. All right, very fast and easy. Okay, so I added a little bit of black here. I'm gonna mix it in with this darkest color here. I want it to be a little more darker now. And then what I've got here, just about like this. And then what I've got here is red, black, and yellow. Maybe I'm gonna take part of this just for fun. I'm gonna start to add some color. So I'm gonna get like a, I'm gonna move this here actually. I'm gonna get like a greenish, like a brownish color. That's what I'm gonna get. But it's leaning towards red more, as you could see right there. Okay. All right. So now I'm gonna add a little bit more white. I ran out. I'm gonna put it on the side of my canvas here. And I'm going to, I'm gonna start with my flat brush, clean it out real quick, so I won't have any darker paint in there. And then dry it out with a paper towel. So I'm gonna use this brush. And here's the white that I just added. And I'm gonna take straight white. And I'm gonna just add, go over some of these and add a little bit of snow on some of these mountains far, far away, okay? Just on some of them. And then maybe bring it down a bit, like I'm, you know. So now here, not everywhere, but you could see I'm still adding some. White snow. Over some of these hills. Okay, continue on with the white. And I'm gonna go over some of these areas. A little bit of this green. All right, moving on, we're gonna add, let's take our number four, Artist Loft, and remember this dark we mixed here? Let's just take that and add a few little rocks far away on top. And I think it's a little too dark, so let's actually take part of this blue, right? Let me clean my palette real quick with a paper towel, so I won't carry too much of that green. So this part of blue, let's just mix it in with a little bit of this. I don't want it to be too dark, far away for those far away ones. But as I get closer, I want them to be a little more darker. So let's just mix it in until we get a nice dark color, but not as dark as this. Okay, right there. So let's use that instead. So that it wouldn't be so dark. And just go over and add wherever you want your rocks to be. You know, the dark shadows and things in your mountains. Wherever you want it. Okay, now I'm going to add a few. Let's add a few right in here. Let's continue using this color. And just dab and create your shapes. Maybe there's some little faraway rocks right in there, like this. You know, just a little bit. I wouldn't overdo it, but just enough. Let's add some in here. Couple in here. Let's dab and create like little trees far away. And dabbing the flat side and just dabbing it, creating far away little trees. Now, of course, we can use a little bit of this black. I dabbed my brush in the water because it was kind of drying the paint. So let's add a few more dark ones in here. Maybe mix it in so it won't be too dark. Let's use this color again and create far away little trees. use this dark because we're now getting closer. So we're going to add a few little trees far away over there, just dabbing it, you know, fade it out. Spread them around, you know, like you choose how far you want them to be spread and all that, you know. Dab my brush in the water. Just continue adding your trees. And obviously as you get closer, that these trees will be a little bigger and taller. So let's go ahead and make some of these a little bit bigger. And here, I'm gonna switch to my Artist Loft number 8 brush real quick. I'm going to just add a little bit of this color. Remember this color that we have here? And I'm gonna just add it, you know, with, just real quick, just add it. I know it's a strong color, but just a little bit right here on the bottom. Dab it in like this, really rough, and fade it out, this color, because as we get closer, we start to see more color. Okay, maybe add some in here as well, so just a little bit of this color, and just, you could even blend it in. And dab my brush, take more of this black, and just roughly. And I use my blending brush to quickly blend everything in. Right here on this side. So I'm going to use my blending brush and squeeze out the water just by itself. Okay, squeezed out the water. And just blend it in. Blend all that in with the background mountains. We want this to be a little bit darker. Right there, and you know, you can go back and with a darker color here, you can just use your flat brush and create a couple, you know, long, like maybe far away little trees. Continue. As much as you want. Have fun with this. And then maybe even go over it with a lighter color here. Just on some of them. Take some of these out of here. I think I added a little too much here. We just want a little bit. There you go. Just a hint. All right, now with a detail brush, we can continue and adding, you know, using this color with water and adding few more detailed ones far away. Okay, just have fun. Add as much as you want. Brush and water. Just go over some of these. Make a couple of these bigger ones because they're up close. add some highlights around your mountain and just detail it as much as you want, okay? And then with the white, same idea. Go over wherever you want your snow to be. Maybe it goes in like this, in there somewhere. There you go. Let's move on to the next thing. Okay, let's continue. And what I've got here is white, titanium white, a touch of blue, and a very small amount of black. Same thing here, white, a little more blue, and a little more black. So it's almost the same, but this has less of the blue and black. So it should be kind of gray, grayish, with a hint of blue in there. This is going to be a road color, our base for the road. Really quickly. That's good enough right there. And then this should be a little darker. Okay, and then right there, and then we have black, a little bit of yellow, and a touch of white right there. Let's mix those. There you go. And now let's just pick up our half an inch flat brush and draw the shape of our, using the darkest color here, the shape of our road, where we want it and how we want it to look, okay? So let's just have it be almost, let's just say almost in the center, right? Like maybe off a little bit, maybe like this. You can have yours in the center if you want. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna draw a little line, because it turns here. I'm gonna bring it down like this, curve it up, and bring it all the way like this, okay? I'm gonna do the same thing here, curve it, and just take it out like this all the way. All right. Yeah, we can make it a little bit even bigger. Like this. Totally up to you. So, since now we have the quick sketch of our road, let's quickly fill that in. So let's take our number 8 and start off with this darker one here. And just all right, next we're going to add the lighter color. This is just our base, okay? And then with the dark one, we mix it in a little bit, fill in the other areas. Roughly, you know. Okay, a little bit dark in here. With the dark, go over some of these for fun and draw shadows and the road. Right. Let's quickly dry this out and we'll add more detail. All right, and now with the detail brush, I'm gonna use white straight out of the tube. So I'm gonna squeeze in a little more white and just white and water, okay? Dab my brush in the water and mix it in here with the white. And far away right here, I'm just gonna follow the road, okay, the pattern of the road. And it goes down like this, and then it picks up here. just with the water. And white. Dab it in the water and continue. So I'm gonna connect these. And then you can use your finger to kind of fade it out if you don't mind doing that. Okay. Just the white. I'm gonna use my number four now. Just the white, same idea. Clean my brush out real quick. And same idea, just the white. Pure white and water, but just want to make some of these. A little more bigger, like this. There you go, that's much better. And just fade it out. It could look a little dirty and messy. That's good enough for the road. Let's add a little more details to it. Okay. Now we're going to take our yellow and a little bit of red to make the those yellow lines right here. I'll show you. I quickly clean my palette knife with a paper towel, and here's a touch of red and a little bit of yellow, just a touch. We want a very small amount. We want that yellow to be maybe a little more, be still yellow, like it's yellow orange. Okay, maybe mix it in with the white so it won't be too bright. That's good enough for now. Maybe actually mix it in a little more red right there. There you go. That's good right there. All right. And let's pick up our flat brush, this one, and then let's start with actually this dark color right here that we mixed and draw the shape of our where we want it to be, those lines. Let's just say one is right in here. It's going out like this. Second one is right next to it. Moving on. So I'm going to pick up my detail brush because it's going to get small really fast. And with the water in this dark color, and I'm just outlining where I want to add. That's good right there. And then I'm going to use my flat brush. Again, go back to my flat brush, clean out the dark. And remember this orange that we mixed? Just quickly take some add it in really quick. My detail brush and kind of blend that in here. Take away some of the black area. Maybe here connects. And then just with the white, let's add a little bit of white on these, just a little bit with the detail brush, so they could stand out a little more. And maybe draw some lines, just white lines. If it has a little bit of yellow, that's okay. Okay, dab the brush in the water again. Just draw a few more. Fade them out. And then maybe with an artist lock brush, and this continues in this dark, you can add over and add some of the dark ones. And a few in here, and we'll call the road good. There you go. All right, so now let's add some shadows using the same color here, and let's create like little, you know, little hills here. just go up to here and let's just cover this bottom part. Just roughly put it in like this. Continue on this side. We're going to add a little bit of this gray right on the bottom, just on some of the areas, this gray right in here, not everywhere, just on some. This really rough. Okay, and then on this side as well, just on some areas. Just the gray. Okay. All right. Next, let's clean our brush and add the white, just pure white, right there, the snow. This will be our snow. And just add the areas where you didn't add the snow. Just dab it and have fun with it. We're gonna come back, but this will be our first base with the white. Let's just stop right there. Oops, I messed up there, no worries. With a paper towel and a finger in the water, like this, I can just wash it off. Like that, there you go. Okay. There, let's continue with just the white. Let's stop right there and let's color in the dark and let's just say just it's going to be about this high and let's fade it out and just color all this in up until this point is fine, like this. And you can fade it out because we're going to, this is our base, we're going to come back to it. Let's do the same thing here. line, just color everything in. All the way up to here. Cover that canvas. Right about there. Back and detail that later, but for now let's just add some trees in here. I'm going to quickly dry this out before I add trees, and we'll add a few more details and we'll be done. Okay, so this is what I have, just black, you could see, and then I've got yellow, a little bit of blue and a touch of white, and then I've got yellow, red, and a little bit of white. Let's mix these. I want to create a green shade. For my trees, I want them to be a little more colorful, not too blue. So I'm going to actually add a little bit of this black, mix it in with the green, just because I don't want it to be too vibrant with the color. I want a hint of that green. Okay, like this. That's much better. Okay, and then it's okay that I have a little bit of green. This one will be leaning towards red, orange. And I will leave it this color, actually. Yeah. Let's leave it this color. I like it. I like this orange. You can see it's bright right there. Okay. And we might, you know, be adding more different kind of shades to the trees and stuff, but let's start with these colors. And first of all, let's just take our flat brush, half an inch, and just this black, and let's draw the trees where we want them to be. So first, I'm going to draw one that's up here, maybe one taller here, one in here, maybe there's one tall one in here, and then maybe there's one in here like this, and one right in behind it. And then let's add a few here. Okay, then I have my brush in the water, and then I'm going to add a few in here. About the same height. Make some of them maybe bigger. Maybe one in here. Okay. Very quickly. Nice and rough. Okay, and then with my number two, I'm going to use this black and add the leaves, just add cover some. Skip a few because I'm going to add a different color to it. So just fade it out. Maybe this one could be a little bit darker here, and then just fade it out like this. Very nice and easy. Maybe there's a far away one like that. There you go. And it fades out. Okay, maybe there's one here. You know, as they get closer, they get a little bigger, okay? Let's fade. Fade it out right there. Just using the black right now. All right, let's do the same thing here. Let's go over some of these trees. Maybe skip a few. This one go all the way down like this, and then moving on, let's add a few big ones here, dark ones. Right, continue in with the black. Let's add this one in here. Maybe a little bit in here. And then I'm going to use my half an inch again, and let's just remember this color, this brown one we have mixed here. Let's just pretend there's a bunch in here, maybe some in here. Some taller ones behind the dark ones. You know, just quickly blend those in. All right, and I'm going to just use the black again to cover some of this, the white areas. Just the canvas, cover the canvas really quickly. That's good enough right there. Maybe bring it down here. All right, and now I'm going to clean my brush and add a little bit of this green, right? A little bit of it. Just a little bit on some of these, just a very small amount. Because we're going to add more details and a few more trees that will have more color up front. This is just the background trees, but we do want to add a little bit of color. So just with the finger, clean it out, make sure it's not too strong. Okay. That's good enough. Just with the green, very, very small amount, you could see. Let's now let's draw a few more trees closer. Continue on with the black and water. And let's just draw one that will be going up in here, and then maybe there's one that's going up like this, and then okay, and then one here. Let's just add this one right in here. let's do the same thing here. Let's add one right there. And then maybe there's one in here like this. And then we're going to add some details. So with the detail brush, let's add the branches, just a few of them, really quickly. If you want. Just messy and quick. Alright, that's fine. I'm going to take my number 8 brush, and I'm going to add this orange. I'm going to add that orange to this tree. And just dab it lightly, just because I want colors in my trees, not just black. Just dab it lightly. Follow your branches, and then you can fade it out. Add some in here, very lightly. Okay. Take a little bit of the black. Just have fun. Create your and then you can go over with the black some of these branches and add, you know, little ones, and connect some. Totally up to you. And then here, to make your snow look more sharper, go over some of these and draw in some of the highlights. And, you know, a few more details just with the white and the detail brush. Let's add some snow up in here, you know, far away, connecting maybe to this mountain. And then maybe there's some snow in here. Few more details. And maybe with this orange, dab it in the water, just outline your trees. You know, on some of them. Okay, and maybe with the black, just the black, go over the some of these trees and add, you know, make it more detailed with a detail brush so they will stand out and not be alone and too naked. All these little details add to the painting. With the white, you can, you know, some of these, fade some of these out like this, so that maybe some snow is coming out on the road a little bit. course, with just the black, we will go over some of these. All right, I can spend a lot of time detailing the road, the trees, whatever I want. You can take a break now and come back to it later and detail it and spend time and having fun. Whatever you want, create it in your own style. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Thank you for tuning in and being patient with me. Let me know what you thought down below in the comments, and be sure to like and subscribe and tune in for next week's video. Take care and God bless.